Monsters is a YouTube channel about the worst human beings on the planet. The episodes of this podcast deal with murder, dismemberment, torture, rape, child abuse, and mental illness. Please turn back while you still can. Viewer discretion is advised. If you want to read more stories about the worst people on the planet, or find ways to support the show, you can visit our blog at thisismonsters.com. Magdalena Luczak and her boyfriend, Marius Krzolak, punished her 4-year-old son by beating him so severely that he slipped into a coma. 2 days later, he was dead. This is Monsters.
Come back and find out that he's deceased.
Tapping me on the head, telling me I'm cheating, telling me I'm, you know, let me see your phone.
Just kill her, and she died.
I think Diego Campioni is totally in the wrong, and I hope he burns in hell for all his sins.
Hell's not a very fun place.
I only have 2 hands. I'm that 4 hands, girl. I'm 2 hands.
And our loans just get escalated.
Eric Pelka and Magdalena Luczak moved to England from Poland in 2005. On July 15th of 2007, Daniel was born. Eric left and moved back to Poland when Daniel was only 1 year old. Luczak had her new boyfriend, Marius Krzolak, move in with her in 2010, and he was referred to as his stepfather, though they were never married. It's not clear what led the couple to decide that Daniel needed the punishment he received. Krzolak told a co-worker that the boy was, quote, all fucked up, end quote, and, quote, a very bad person, end quote. He told the same co-worker that Daniel was, quote, retarded and should be sent back to his biological father in Poland, end quote. Krzolak had spent a year in the Polish army and used that experience to devise punishments that would hasten Daniel's emaciation. On January 5th of 2011, not long after Krzolak moved in, Daniel suffered a broken arm, but Luczak didn't take him to the hospital until the following day. She told the doctors that he had been jumping on the sofa with his sibling and then complained of pain the following day. The doctor found multiple bruises where the boy had suffered a spiral fracture in his upper arm. Out of suspicion, the doctor contacted Child Protective Services and reported the incident. Investigators asked Daniel's sibling what had happened, and when she confirmed the story, they closed the case. Later that year, when Daniel started attending a new school, his teachers said he started out looking well cared for. By the end of the year, though, they were noticing him acting more and more hungry. He eventually got caught stealing food out of the other children's lunchboxes. When the teacher spoke with Luczak, she was told that Daniel had a hereditary eating disorder and was seeing a doctor. She also said that having him eat more food would interfere with his medication, so the school began locking up the lunchboxes in the office. The school reported a number of other instances where the boy arrived at school with injuries, bruises around his neck, black eyes, and a cut on his forehead, but no serious action was ever taken by social services. The police were also called to the family's residence for domestic abuse issues. The truth of what was going on in the home of Luczak and Krzolak was far worse than anyone could have imagined. Daniel was locked in a tiny room for most of the time he was there. It had nothing but a filthy mattress on the floor that was stained from him wetting the bed. The door handle had been removed from the inside of the room so he couldn't leave. The room served as his bathroom as well and reeked of human waste. Daniel was not fed when he was at home, unless you count the mother and boyfriend force-feeding him salt as a means of dehydrating him faster. He had a history of wetting the bed, which is common with children who are abused, and he would be beaten when it happened. It is speculated that this was the cause of the abuse that eventually killed him. Authorities believe that Krzolak beat the boy and then Luczak took him to the bath where she held him underwater until he was unconscious. She then put him in his room where he died and she eventually called 999. An autopsy revealed Daniel had 22 injuries at the time of his death and 10 of them were to his head. The medical examiner determined his cause of death was from a brain injury. He weighed only 23 pounds at the time, the average weight of an 18-month-old baby. Both Luczak and Krzolak denied causing the boy's death, but there was quite a bit of evidence that proved that they were lying. Investigators found that they had made 55 internet searches related to overdosing on table salt and how to care for someone in a coma. They also had several text messages that Luczak and Krzolek had sent back and forth discussing the abuse. These have been translated from Polish to English, so some of the syntax is off. October 7th, 2011, 8:46 a.m., sent from Krzolek. Quote, Magda, lead him to the room and lock him there. You'll have some peace and do wait for me, end quote. 9:15 a.m., sent by Luczak. Quote, we'll deal with Rudy after school. He won't see grub at all. I'm going home now. Call me on your break, end quote. Rudy was Daniel's nickname. 12:24 p.m., sent by Luczak. Quote, let's buy the white stuff instead of vodka today. We would have some fun later and you could sit at the computer and look for a car, end quote. I think it's reasonable to assume the white stuff is cocaine. October 21st of 2011, 6:43 a.m., sent by Luczak. Quote, when you're going to the shop, then do remove Rudy's door handle so Daniel's sibling won't be opening the door for him, end quote. February 2nd, 2012, 10:21 a.m., sent by Luczak. Quote, well, now he's temporarily unconscious because I nearly drowned him. He's already in bed covered with the duvet and asleep, and I'm having some quiet time, end quote. 10:24 a.m., sent by Luczak. Quote, I won't be hitting him, but if I hear him when he later wakes up, then he's going back in the bathtub. I didn't let the water out, end quote. 4:34 p.m., sent by Luczak. Quote, he'll get over it by tomorrow. There's no point to stress ourselves out and to call an ambulance because that will cause proper problems, end quote. Then, the evidence that really sealed the fate of Luczak and Krzolek was the testimony of Daniel's sibling, who has not been named to protect the minor. They confirmed that they saw Daniel being held underwater by Luczak on March 3rd. They claimed that Krzolek bashed the boy's head into the side of the tub. In August of 2013, both Magdalena Luczak and Mariusz Krzolek were sentenced to life in prison. In the judge's statement, she said, quote, harrowing details of the unimaginable acts of cruelty and brutality inflicted on little Daniel over many months have exposed both of the torment and despair he must have suffered and your callous disregard for his pain and distress, end quote. On July 14, 2015, Magdalena Luczak was found dead in her cell. She had committed suicide by hanging herself. On January 27, 2016, Mariusz Krzolek was found dead in his cell. He had complained earlier about chest pains, but refused medical treatment because he was afraid people at the hospital would recognize him. His death was ruled a heart attack. If you like these videos, please hit subscribe, click like, or leave me a comment. If you'd like to support the channel, you can donate a few bucks through Buy Me a Coffee. You can click the link within the YouTube banner or go to buymeacoffee.com/monsters. Another way you can support the channel is by using our Amazon link anytime you're going to buy something at Amazon. You can go to our website at thisismonsters.com and click through the Amazon banner. Anytime you're already going to buy something from Amazon, you can click through that link and buy your items at no additional charge, and we get a small commission. I'm always working to provide more content at better quality, and your support helps me do that. I thank you in advance.